Mr. Sushant Pai, CFO. So without further delay, I would like to hand over the call to Mr. Murjawel to provide a brief overview of the quarter gone by, and then we can move on to the Q&A session. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Thank you very much, Deep. Good evening, everyone. Yeah, I hope everyone is able to hear me. I hope all of you are continue to stay safe and healthy. India witnessed a severe second wave of the pandemic, and many of our associates and their family members were also infected. We as a company put health and well-being of our people at the forefront. Some of the initiatives we rolled out for the people were special leave, financial assistance, reimbursements of test costs and vaccination costs, online free consultation, enhanced insurance cover, help desk related to COVID, webinar by doctor, etc. We also accelerated our CSR initiative to help the society by contributing rupees 50 lakhs to the Tamil Nadu CM Public Relief Fund and about rupees 20 lakhs towards various other COVID-related initiatives. Given this background, I'm happy to state that we overcame many challenges and we have reported a strong start for FY22 with a good year-on-year growth on billing and profitability. As indicated earlier, our strategic initiatives continue to yield results, and our focus in product enhancement and customer experience will us to enhance this growth momentum. In quarter one, on a consolidated basis, we achieved a rupees 105.2 crores of billing, indicating a decline of 1.4% quarter over quarter and a growth of 29% year on year. This is a slight decline on a quarter over quarter basis, as the lockdowns did have some impact in April and May, but the momentum enhanced in June. For matchmaking, the key highlights are as follows. In quarter one, the billing was rupees 104.7 crore, a decline of 1.3% quarter over quarter and a growth of 29% year on year. Revenue at rupees 104.9 crore, a growth of 4.2% quarter over quarter and 21.8% year on year. We added 2.2 lakhs paid subscription during the quarter, a growth of 31.6% year on year. We continue to see good double-digit growth in volume and billings in North and Western market, which have high competition intensity. AT for matchmaking business increased 1.6% quarter over quarter, but declined 1.9% year on year. We continue to track the impact we create for our customers. We are happy to state that we have created about 26,485 success stories in quarter one. Other highlights for the quarter. During the July 2021, the company has signed a definite agreement to acquire a 100% stake in Boatman Tech Private Limited, promoters of ShadiSaga.com, as approved by its board of directors. The acquisition will be by the way of share purchase from the existing shareholders for an aggregate consideration of rupees 11 crore, subject to adjustment at the time of closing. The transaction is subject to customary closing condition and regulatory approvals. We expect to close the transaction this month. Founded in 2015, ShadiSaga is a leading player in wedding services industry with over 40,000 vendors across multiple services and catering to customers across 15 major cities in the country. Through a robust digital presence, built with strong social media and content marketing capabilities, ShadiSaga has garnered a consistent demand of around 1 million monthly active users. With its technology-focused approach, ShadiSaga offers a differentiated product experience. Following this acquisition, ShadiSaga founders will join Matrimony.com in senior leadership role. With this strategic acquisition, we'll accelerate our growth through supply enhancement and superior product capabilities. We intend to integrate ShadiSaga product technology and social media assets with our offering, that is WeddingBazaar.com and Mandap.com. With this approach, we believe that the deal will significantly strengthen our positioning, and which includes both WeddingBazaar.com and Mandap.com, and which enable both the brands become a number one wedding services brand pan India. Now coming to the marriage services business results, revenue was rupees 0.6 crore, a growth of 19.1% year on year. Losses in the quarter was rupees 2.1 crore as compared to rupees 1.9 crore in quarter four. On the billing and revenue outlook for quarter two, we have now delivered four consecutive quarters of year-on-year double-digit billing growth in matchmaking, and we expect this momentum to continue. along with the growth in profitability. We expect the Q2 matchmaking billing and revenue to show a double-digit growth on a year-on-year basis and a single-digit growth on a quarter-over-quarter basis. Wedding Services expect to grow from Q1 levels. ShaadiSaga will be consolidated post-closing of the transaction, which is expected by this month. The contribution from ShaadiSaga will be insignificant in this quarter. Let me now pass on to Sushanth to comment on the key profitability items. Sushanth, over to you.
Yeah. Thanks, Murugavel. Our EBITDA margin for the matchmaking business in Q1 has improved strongly to 27.7% as compared to 23.4% in quarter four and 25.1% a year ago. We are progressing well in our journey to achieve 30% EBITDA margins in due course. Marketing expenses are at 37.3 crores as compared to rupees 38.6 crores in quarter four. The EBITDA margins have improved strongly despite salary increments given in quarter one, mainly due to reduced infra expenses due to lockdown and also revenue increase. Excluding marketing expenses, our margins in matchmaking are at 63% in quarter one as compared to 62% in quarter four and 56% a year ago. On a consolidated basis, our EBITDA margins in Q1 are at 21.6% compared to 17.7% in quarter four and 18.6% a year ago. We have now crossed 20% mark even on a consolidated basis, and we expect this momentum to continue. On an absolute basis, EBITDA has grown by 27.9% quarter-on-quarter and 40.9% year-on-year. Tax rate is at 25.3% for the quarter. PAT, excluding Astro, which are our associate company, is at rupees 14.1 crore, a growth of 39.2% quarter-on-quarter and 46.9% year-on-year, which is again a strong growth in profitability. Share of loss from Astro is rupees 27 lakhs. Our free cash generation for the quarter has been robust at rupees 16 crores, indicating 0.84 times to EBITDA, and our cash balance is at rupees 302 crores. Return on equity is at 21%. On the outlook for Q2 margins, we expect EBITDA and PAT to show a good double-digit growth both on a quarter-on-quarter and a Y-on-Y basis, and we expect this trend to continue for the remainder of the year as well. I would like to end with a customary safe harbor statement. Certain statements during this call could be forward-looking statements on our business. These involve a number of risks and uncertainties that could cause the actual results to differ materially from such forward-looking statements. We do not undertake to update any such forward-looking statements that may be made from time to time by or on behalf of the company unless it is required by law. Over to you, Deep, for Q&A.
Thank you, sir. Participants wanting to ask questions, kindly raise your hand from the bottom right corner of the screen. We shall then unmute your lines. Participants who've joined via the call, they could ask their questions in the Q&A, and we'll take them up. We shall wait for a moment till the question queue assembles. Just another announcement. Participants who've dialed in via the call, please press star and six to ask your questions. So as we wait for the question queue to build up, sir, I have a couple of questions from my end. Firstly, could you please elaborate the more on Shaadi Saada acquisition? You have explained that you have changed your strategy now in the marriage services business, but how would you like to look at this acquisition, especially that it is largely for the northern market?
Thank you, Deep. This Shaadi Saada acquisition, in a way, it's significant for multiple reasons. One is that we have moved to a subscription-based business model on wedding services in the beginning of the last financial year. And also for the wedding services marketplace model, there are a couple of things that are important. One is that the good number of listing on the supply side. And while you are strong in certain parts of India, south and to certain parts of India, because these wedding services primarily started in the south, and Shaadi Saada has a good presence in the north and western market. So in a way, this helps us to become a strong leader in terms of listing across India, because also Shaadi Saada has built a good social media presence. They have close to 1 million visitors on a monthly basis. So we'll help her to enhance our offerings in terms of product side, listing side. So these are the benefits, plus also in terms of product, they definitely build a super differentiated and the product experience. So we see the benefit in terms of product and also the founders have certain credibility and they are invested years of in this venture. So the founders joining at a senior position, wedding services, the listing and the social media presence and the product, and all this will help the wedding service business to scale up. The wedding is a large business. Somehow, so far, no one made it as big in this category. Hope that with the acquisition of Shaadi Saada, we expect the wedding services business to grow on a strong basis. Our base is very small, but we expect post this integration from Q3 onwards, we expect the wedding services to a strong uptake in the growth side. So to sum it up, the benefits on the product, social media presence, and on the listing side, plus the founders' years of experience in this wedding services operation, it all be beneficial. Plus, we're adding leadership capabilities in this space.
Right. Thank you, sir. The next question is from the line of Archit Singhal. Archit, we have unmuted you. Please go on.
Yeah. Hi. Can you hear me?
Yes, Archit Singhal, I can hear you.
Congrats team on good set of numbers, and I mean it's good to see the margin improvement. So couple of questions. Firstly, Sushant, if you can answer this one. So marketing spends have come down sequentially, and I think that is one of the reasons why the margins have gone up. So are you seeing reduction in competitive intensity because of which the marketing spends have come down?
Yeah. So in terms of EBITDA margins, not only the marketing spends, obviously marketing spends have come down by 1 crore. That is also the reason why EBITDA margins have improved. But having said that, the competition intensity has not relented. In the sense, there is still high competition intensity. But like we told you earlier, we see how much we want to spend for the quarter depending on our trajectory of the business as well as competition intensity. And we do a balance of both. Given that we had a little slower April month than what we had expected because of the intense lockdown and severe second wave that happened, that's why we sort of tweaked our marketing expenses a bit. Having said this, I think in next quarter, the marketing expenses will increase slightly from the current levels because we did tweak it in quarter one. We may bring it slightly on the upper side in quarter two, but that is not going to affect our trajectory on profitability. Like we said in the call, that the profitability will continue to increase in spite of the marketing expenses increase. The other reason why the EBITDA margin increased is also obviously revenue increased, right? From a quarter on quarter basis, also the revenue increased. The second thing that also happened was we also got some benefit because of the lockdown in terms of the offices were not running, in terms of power, in terms of rental, certain things, we got some leeway, and that sort of also contributed to the EBITDA margin.
Archit, just to add to what Sushant said, it's mainly on account of the revenue.
The benefits, all that's a small benefit. As Sushant said, in spite of increasing marketing spend in quarter two, we expect a double-digit growth on the revenue side, and the profit continued to grow very strongly. So,
Understood. And on the growth, I mean, if you can, so growth has come back, and I mean, if you can highlight what are the key reasons which is driving this growth? Is it the product innovation and the new categories where you are entering which is driving this growth?
It's basically our leadership team has been able to execute very well, because we are continue looking at the way to increase the conversions. So we see that year on year, the conversion has been growing very well. So that we expect that moment to continue, mainly on account of our ability to convert free members into paid members, on account of multiple things. The continuous product improvements and our execution capabilities, all these factors have been contributing to the increase in growth. Plus also investing in some of the product areas, some of the newer businesses. So combination of multiple factors have been driving our growth.
Understood. Two more things from my side. Firstly, I mean, if you can highlight on the pricing per se, and in the annual report you have mentioned about NRI markets and all. So do you see going forward pricing also to improve? I mean, we are seeing the improvement in paid subscribers, but anything on pricing if you can comment?
Yeah, actually we see that our ARPU as in tweaking and continue to drive, you know, wherever possible, try to get the better pricing possible, and wherever required, we also discount so that, you know, the customer can convert better. So basically, we look at both the things, so that, you know, one hand we try to drive the ARPU, and one hand we are also look at increase the number of paid subscription. So we drive on both the fronts.
Understood. And last thing from my side, like Murugavel, you mentioned growth should be double digit going forward also. And earlier there were comments that marketing spends would be calibrated in the same range. So fair to assume that with growth coming back in double digits, because of operating leverage, your margins should increase from these levels, and I mean, should continue to increase?
Yeah, as Sushant mentioned, we expect the margin to, because you look at the matchmaking, the margin at now almost at 27%+. We expect the due course touching 30%, okay, on the matchmaking side. And enterprise EBITDA margin across 20%, we expect that to further to move up. So while the marketing spend continue to, you know, increase to drive the growth and also to take care of that increased competitive activities, but however, we expect the revenue growth and billing growth to continue, or margin also to continue. So yes, so actually to conclude, yes, we expect the margin to further move up from here on both on the matchmaking level as well as on the enterprise level.
Thank you.
Before we take the next question, participants can press star and 3 to raise their hands. Participants joined in using the call can press star and 6 to ask a question. Then we have a next question in the chat from the line of Mr. Khush Dosrani. Sir, he wants to ask whether the Shaadi Saga is more of an Pinterest model where you can see the listings and contact the vendors directly. What is the model? He wants to understand it better.
Yeah, the business model is a subscription business model. Basically, our revenue coming from vendors paying money to get better visibility and increased leads from us. So, and as far as the customers who are looking for these wedding services, they come to the portals and they reach out to the vendors who are on the match wedding services platform. However, the paid vendors will get a better visibility and better leads. So business model is subscription, which is coming from the vendors in the wedding services space.
Right. We have another question in the chat box. So that question is more, they want to understand more about your marketing spends. The question is that how long do you think this will continue, and whether these are the peak marketing levels?
No, difficult to comment because one hand, because there's definitely the competition intensity is continuing, and so we need to invest in some of the areas. Obviously, we are not investing it appropriately. We need to invest, and also as a company, we are looking at expanding to newer geographies. We're also looking at launching a new product offering. So it's a combination of all these things, our geography expansion, new product offering, and the competitive intensity. So with all these factors, pushing us to, invest on the marketing side, we expect that the marketing spend to continue. However, as Sushant said, which definitely is going to help us in the double-digit growth, as even with increased marketing spend, we expect the margin to improve on both at the enterprise level and the matchmaking level. So yes, that's outlook currently.
Right. So another question was on your international expansion. So there was a time when we had planned to go outside India. Now, how is that plan? Do we still see a lot of scope there, or we will first focus only on the northern markets before going out of India?
No, definitely. As far as international expansion, pretty much on the cards. We expect Bangladeshi operations to commence from before the end of this quarter. And we're also working towards the launch of Sri Lankan Matrimony or the operation in Sri Lanka, hopefully before the end of quarter three. We also have a MuslimMatch.com. That's a global matchmaking service for the global Muslim. And it's completely currently online. As far as the physical operations concerned, it's going to be in Bangladesh for Bangladeshi Matrimony. It's going on for Sri Lanka, for Sri Lankan Matrimony. While continue to look at the growing the matchmaking business in India, wedding services business in India, we're also looking at global opportunities also as a part of our growth strategies.
Right, sir. Participants, before we take the next question, just a reminder to press star and 3 to raise hands. The next questions are from Mr. Devan, but Mr. Devan, we have unmuted you. You may please ask your questions.
Hi sir, thank you for taking my question. Just in your paid subscriber has declined by 2.9%. Your ATV is up by 1.6%, but the matchmaking revenue is up by 4.3%. So can you explain us the difference? I also have following follow up questions, but first if you could.
So when you look at the paid subscription 2.9 and ATV 1.6, right, you need to look at actually the billing, not the revenue, because the paid subscription is based on the billing number. So that's how it matches. So if you look at 2.9 and 1.6, the net impact will be about 1.3%, and which is what is shown in the quarter on quarter basis.
So what is what would be the breakup of matchmaking services in this quarter?
So that is given, right? You're talking about billing?
The paid subscriber and ATV growth, if you could give us the growth of both of them.
So that's given. So 2.9 is the decline in paid subscription, right? ATV increased by 1.6. So therefore, the
net... That's on billing, right?
That's on billing.
I'm talking about the revenue.
No, revenue, we don't track it like that, because the ATV is based on the subscription amount that is received, and then it goes on a amortize it over the period of the package. So you have to see it from the billing wise only.
Okay. So your billing is down QOQ, but what gives you the confidence of getting a higher revenue growth on a QOQ basis?
Yeah, so what happens is that the billing was down on a QOQ basis because quarter four there was an impact in terms of how the revenue was shaping quarter one because of quarter four and quarter one. Now because in quarter two we are again seeing a particular billing and particular trajectory, that's how the revenue comes. So it depends on, it's like this, revenue accounting is based on how the billing shapes up from month to month. So if, for example, if in a particular month it is lower in the beginning of the month, then it affects more in the same quarter of, or rather in the same quarter itself. Suppose the billing is high towards the third month of the quarter, then it impacts, or rather you get higher revenue in the next quarter. So it's like that, because predominantly our packages are in the 3 month category. So therefore that's how the revenue shapes up.
Just to add to what Sushant said, the Q1, the billing was impacted in April and May, and it's bounced in the month of June. So the what are the increased billing in June? We have that the bearing on the Q2. So because April May plus impact, it also had an impact in the billing in the quarter one. So Q2, yeah, we expect that the revenue to continue because of the billing, increased billing we saw in June, and 2/3 of the benefits coming in this quarter. Plus also the Q2 has been we expect year on year the double digit growth to continue.
This growth will be high single digit or a low single digit?
Not able to hear.
So this growth will be a high single digit QOQ or a low single digit QOQ growth, and will it continue for next quarters?
So basically, our Q2 matchmaking and billing will grow double digit on a Y on Y basis and a single digit on a quarter quarter basis. We are not saying whether it is high or low because we need to see how, for example, August shapes up, September shapes up and all of that. So right now we are just leaving it at a single digit basis. So if we do, you know, very well in August, you know, then that can increase more, right? So we'll
at this point, I'm saying that the year on year double digit growth and profit trajectory will continue. We had a close to 50%. It can even get better on profit side. So we expect the profit to improve better and the billing and our double digit growth.
So your profit trajectory will be similar to this Q1 quarter, is it?
We may expect better profit also year on year basis.
Okay. Year over year basis.
Yeah.
Okay. And then has your pricing stabilized? The mix that you were changing in terms of subscribers, has it stabilized now?
And pricing, the combination of different packages. So we continue to figure out, as I said, there is a personalized services which are sold at higher packages. So that kind of similar level or may slightly more depends on how we're able to, you know, convert the users into various packages. So we expect it to be the similar range or maybe slightly get better, depends on how the quarter ends.
Thank you for taking
very difficult to, you know, kind of put a number to it, but our strategy has been that, you know, continue to do what it takes to convert and also where it's possible to get better subscription at a right ARPU, which we try to do that.
Thank you for taking my question. Thank you
Devang.
So before we take the next question, participants on the call, you need to press star and six. Participants via the link, press star and three to ask questions. We have one question from a Tolin user. We have unmuted your line. If you could just introduce yourself first and then ask the question.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah, this is Dhruv.
Hi, Shishant,
and hi, Murugan. Congratulations on a really good set of numbers.
Yeah, thank you.
Murugan, you have alluded in the past that we want to grow double digit, but when do we see a run rate of 500 crores? Can we see 500 crores on an exit this year?
That's
making.
Yeah, he hope you get to that number, Dhruv, okay?
Yeah, but if you say a quarter on quarter single digit kind of growth, we can exit on a run rate of 500.
Yeah,
is it possible?
Yeah, we hope that, you know, it's possible, you know, kind of able to get to the number.
Right. And Sushant, to reach that number, do we have to spend a lot on marketing? Because I guess two quarters back, you said is the max you want to go, and today you're saying that you might have to increase that. So a word on the marketing expenses?
Yeah, so what we are saying is, yes, if you remember, we had said that marketing expenses is a function of our growth trajectory and also competition intensity. We'll balance both. We had also said, you're right, that, even though competition is going to spend more, we'll be in a particular range sort of a thing. But you'll have to keep, revisiting this. Right now, our thing is that, yes, we are now in the 37, 38. That will increase further in quarter two within our range that what we had said. Now, what we will spend in Q3 and Q4, we will again look at it at that time. But right now, you know, it looks like that, you know, it will increase from this level onwards. But whether we want to go much beyond what we had indicated earlier, we'll take a call as we go along. But broadly, you know, that call is also going to be taken depending on a growth trajectory. If the growth trajectory is good, even if we increase marketing a bit, we can still, you know, keep our momentum in terms of increasing EBITDA and PAT, you know, on a quarter-on-quarter basis. So broadly, our plan is that we want to increase, you know, billing on a double-digit Y-on-Y basis quarter-on-quarter, and also improve profitability on a double-digit Y-on-Y basis quarter-on-quarter, even, you know, on a quarter-on-quarter basis. So I think as long as we keep track of it, the marketing will be, you know, like a number that we keep tweaking depending on both factors.
Right.
Just to add to what Sushant said, you know, there are the multiple things. Yeah. One is that definitely the increased competitive activities. And we also have the growth plans. We also expanding to international operations and other countries. We also have the product offering. So there are multiple things. We also know the looking at the wedding services also, but what is the losses will be in a similar range. So there are multiple things. So we expect that, as Sushant said, marketing is a function of our growth trajectory and plus competitive the marketing spend. So what you are looking at broadly, strong, good double-digit growth and profit moving up and strongly, and these are the two things I'm looking at. So top-line growth and profit growing strongly. A couple of things will be variable, depends on that, as Sushant said, you know, our growth trajectory or growth initiatives plus what we see in the market.
Right. I have two more questions. Morgan, I guess we ended June on a very good note. Is it because during Q4 numbers, you said that our billings would degrow much more than what you have shown? So was June a really good quarter for month for us?
Yeah, really. June, we did. I guess the moment I picked up from summer, the May, you know, because when you had the analyst call, you know, kind of the outlook was not so good because it was a severe lockdown. And the momentum picked after that, yes, June we delivered well. Yes. So
would June be better than Feb or March? If yes, I have yes. to compare like that?
Yes, June is
it. Right. And my last question will be, after the acquisition, do we expect EBITDA loss in our wedding services business to go above the range of, say, about 1.5 to 2 crores on a quarterly basis?
No, we are at around 2 crore. It will be in a similar range for this quarter as well. And we don't see any significant increase in losses. And again, probably one quarter down the line, post-integration, we also expect that the billing momentum to move up in wedding services from quarter 3 onwards. So the outlook at this point in time, the loss will be around the 2 crores.
Okay. Okay, great guys, and congratulations once again on a really good set of numbers. Thank you so much.
The next question is from the line of Mr. Manivanan Kanan. Mr. Kanan, we have unmuted you. If you can just ask a question, please. I guess he's maybe on mute or not available. There's another caller calling in. We have unmuted your line. If you could just introduce yourself and ask your question, please.
We are not able to hear.
Yeah, sir, your voice is not audible. We have unmuted you. If you could introduce yourself and ask your question, please. Okay, Mr. Kanan has sent his question in the chat, so I'll just ask from his behalf. So the question is, in spite of three players aggressively investing money, the industry growth is tepid, unlike other new age industries which solve much lower needs. I feel it is because there is no repeat business opportunity from users. A satisfied user on other platforms will do business more, whereas a satisfied user on Matrimony will get married and churn out. So the industry can grow at a great speed. What is your view on this small opportunity, sir?
That's a, you know, kind of in terms of compared to other internet businesses, we don't repeat users, the other internet business, yes, you are right. Once you acquire a customer, once you become satisfied customer, they can be possibly for a lifelong customer, or probably they can transfer for long time. Yes, so in this case, the matchmaking, yes, once satisfied customers, where you have to end up in losing them, that's a fact, that's the nature of the business. However, India definitely has the number of users looking at getting married, and the level of online penetration definitely is improving. Yes, there is intense competition, and there are various reasons. It could be that, why the thing is not moving up. One is that it's because the point what you already said, that the people get married and they leave the website. The number of news is coming also that because of today, the multiple players, and today people are trying to kind of eat into each other market share. That's what's trying to happen. So the number of new people coming, yes, there's been growth. It's growing at a double-digit basis. And we expect that momentum to continue. Whether it will be going to grow at at a higher percentage, it may not be the case. The reason is that for other industry, why you see the multiplier effect much stronger? Because existing users are transacting again and again. In this case, the new users keep, well, the new user base is growing, but not growing at a 30-40%. It can't grow at that base. It can grow at a double-digit pace. I think industry growing at the reasonable pace, I think that's what you can expect, the overall user base growing at probably a double-digit basis, the business growing at double-digit basis. I think that is the reasonable expectation you can have in the business. Unlike other e-commerce businesses, while you can have the existing users keep coming and buying it, plus they're also buying more services, that may not happen in this category. Yes, is there opportunity to grow? Yes, there's opportunity to grow because the number of people looking for life partner vis-a-vis the number of people are getting married, there's definitely opportunity to grow. But the growth will be in the user profile growth only at double degree. And otherwise, you come up with new innovative ways to kind of drive the growth. We continue to figure out what else can be done to either increase that user base. However, is one thing about driving that number of users coming on the platform. That's one thing. Again, the revenue is a function of what percentage of those users going to become paid member. Okay. So while today a certain percentage of users going for a paid membership, and we continue to do a product improvements and various strategies to get more people go for paid subscription. So there's another way to drive the growth is, yes, one on that the number of users signing up with the platform going up. Other way to drive the growth is converting the more number of users going for a paid transaction. So we continue to work on both these areas. And while the thing is that there's a positive outlook, there's a growth momentum. We expect the momentum to continue. We expect only to further move up. Yes, there's increased competition. It's sort of in a way that it's a challenge. But however, as a leader in this space, we're executing very well. We are widening the gap between us and the other players. In fact, we're widening the absolute revenue gap between the other players in the industry. Widening the gap, we continue to execute very well. We continue to work on the ways to get more people to go for the paid membership and also try to get more people to sign for the matchmaking platform. Yes, the nature of this business is not like other thing, but however, this business in a way that, which is strongly entrenched in terms of when it comes to matchmaking, obviously Matrimony is definitely one of the most preferred brand. So as long as humanity exists, the matchmaking will continue. So that way, this business, in a way, the eternity or the longevity of this business is very high. And so that way, while there are some challenges like, we don't have repeat business, there are a lot of positive about it. In fact, among all the internet business paying for subscription, matchmaking is where people pay for highest number of subscription. Because today, people pay almost 5,000 rupees for digital subscription. No other digital subscription business get this kind of output. This talks about the people belief in this category and matrimony.com. So that way, there are a lot of positive around it. And so we continue to work on the ways to increase, drive the growth. So, and again, more importantly, we're satisfied as a company that because we consider matchmaking one of the noble service. So like how healthcare, how education, we truly believe that matchmaking is a very noble profession. So yes, immense satisfaction, in getting a millions of people married.
Right, sir. We have the toll in user back. If you could please introduce yourself and ask your question.
Hello.
Yes, you're audible. Yes, you're audible. Please introduce yourself and ask your question.
Yeah, hi, hello. This is Mohit here from HDFC Securities. So I basically had one question, sir. So with respect to, we have spoken about this in the previous calls as well regarding the increased popularity of the dating app, right? So now in South being your major market, so we have these regional dating apps also which have come up and have become popular. Like one is, I think, by the name of Anbe. One is by the name of Arike, which is for which targets the Malayalam community. And Anbe, I think, targets the Tamil community. So there's a regional specific dating apps which have come up. So do you feel that, you know, this could be, you know, one more layer of competition for your business, and it could impact the, you know, the growth in paid profiles?
Mohit, as I said, in the past, we don't see the dating sites or any real competition to matrimony business. Look at all the dating sites, no one even crossed a couple of millions of dollars of business, in spite of some of the players there being in the market for more than a decade also. So that's why the dating is something which is has a low penetration, and the user base is completely different. Their challenge are getting female audience. So even the largest dating site in India not even cost $2 million revenue. So you don't see dating as any the significant competition to matrimony business. And we also don't see that this kind of, you know, overlapping with the people looking for the matrimony. So we don't see definitely any significant comment from wedding services. And so we don't see that as a challenge.
Okay. And so my one more next question is with respect to pricing, right? So it's a combination of various packages, with right from the basic package to the premium packages. So if I understand correctly, so because the ARPU has shot up because of the decline in subscriber base from Q4 to Q1, is my and there's no major change in your pricing. So is the understanding correct on that part?
No, actually, Mohit, while the number of paid transaction dropped on account of the challenges what we faced in April, May, on account of COVID lockdown. Otherwise, the billing volume would have grown compared to the earlier quarter. So ARPU has nothing to do with the drop in the paid transaction. The ARPU is a function of, as you rightly said, it's the mix of various packages. It depends on which package you're able to sell in a particular quarter. The ARPU slightly increases or decreases.
Okay, got it, sir. Thank you so much.
So we have one more question in the chat. The question is regarding your employee cost. So the question here is, would we see an increase in hiring now as things open up? How should we look at the employee cost line item?
See, the employee cost is around at enterprise level, around 32%. And we expect it will be a sort of at a similar level. And as the revenue grows, the employee cost as a percentage may even come down, because we know to invest so much of, we know to invest in the corresponding employee cost. So that's a nature of business. At economic of scale, when the revenue increases, the cost, be it infrastructure cost, be it employee cost, even the marketing cost, it should come down. So we don't see that, while we're definitely investing in certain areas, but however, we don't see that employee cost, it's moving up. It will be, as you progress, it may even come down further.
Right. So participants, again, a reminder, if you have any questions, kindly press star and 3 or star and 6. We'll wait for a moment in case there are any more questions. So we have one more question from Toller. Yes, sir, you have been unmuted. If you could please introduce yourself and ask your question.
Hey, hi, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Hi, this is Rajesh Kotharia from Alpha Equity Advisors. I just have one question, that in terms of the, you know, the consumer behavior in last 3, 4, 5, 6 months, are you seeing any trends over there? This strong growth of 29% on YOY basis, is it just due to the low base? Because if I look at first quarter FY20, you had a 92 crore of billing. Compared to first quarter FY21, it was 82 crore. So of course, the base was very low, and therefore it is 30% growth. But as we move forward, it be more like a double digit, low double digit kind of a growth. That's what you are guiding for.
Yes, Rajesh, because the last year Q1 we are severely impacted because the base was low. This quarter we had strong double digit growth in terms of the billing. So yeah, but definitely we'll be looking at going forward year on basis, there'll be a double digit growth, but it won't be likes of 29% or 30% year on year. We'll definitely have a double digit growth.
Okay. So when you say, double, so basically you are saying that that 110, 125 crores, that basically over a period of time, Q-on-Q basis, by fourth quarter exit rate, you can reach to what, 120 crore kind of thing? That's what you are looking for?
No, we'll continue to conduct our double-digit growth quarter on quarter. Yes, it's a hope to get to that that number and before the end of the year. That's our that's we are working towards it. Yeah.
Okay, and to my first question, that in terms of the behavior of the consumers in last 3-5 months, any trends to understand, any major difference?
No, we don't see anything. Nothing has changed significantly in last, or even to some extent in the last couple of quarters or anything like that. One thing that definitely during the COVID definitely has accelerated the digital adoption in India, and so more and more people are now open to online for various services. So that way, that not only for us, there is generally there's the good digital adoption taking place in India.
Okay. Fine, sir. Thank you, sir. Wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Sir, we have one more question from Mr. Sunil Kumar. He's asking, are you looking at some big matrimony player acquisition in the northern Hindi markets?
At this point of time, you are focusing on our growth, and we continue to focus on our improving our product and drive the conversions. If at all any opportunities arises in the future, we'll evaluate that point of time.
Thank you, sir. So, given there are no more questions, over to you, sir, for any closing remarks.
So thank you, Deep, and thank you everyone for participating in the conference call. And I hope everyone can continue to stay safe and stay healthy, and look forward to connect in the next quarter. And Susan, is there anything you want to add?
No, nothing much. I think we've discussed everything. In case you have any questions or any specific queries, do feel free to write to me or to our IR consultants as well, Valorem Advisors. So look forward to keeping in touch. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you once again, and appreciate your interest and participation. Thank you.
Thank you for joining this call. On behalf of Bain Securities, have a good evening. Thank you so much.
There's something on top. There's a leaf. Oh, close it. That's on top of it.